Hey guys, and welcome back to another Eye Contrast video. Today I thought I might do something a little bit different and help out all those people that would like to be a little bit more smoother with their controls in F1 2017. I've personally played F1 games since F1 2010, so it's been a while, and I do have a fair bit of experience. But this by all means does not make me the best player of the game. Either way, I thought I might share some of my experience with you guys and it may be beneficial. While I'm making this video for F1 2017, it pretty much applies to every other racing game that's somewhat realistic. So anyways, let's get straight into the video. You may believe that wheel users have a lot more of an advantage compared to controller users, just due to the fact that they have 360 degrees of rotation and they can be a lot more precise when changing direction. While this is true, there are certain measures we can take as pad users to limit the deficit to wheel users. So let's now go over some of the tips and tricks over the years that I've acquired that will hopefully prove beneficial for all of you. Starting off with the steering input, you may think all we have is just this analog stick. While this is true, we also have a rim around the analog stick. So rather than going from side to side, try going up and down through the arc of the rim, and that will give you a lot more smoother transition from left to right. Second of all, wheel users have pedals to control the brakes and throttle. Now, while we only have triggers, we can do our best to modulate the throttle of the car by squeezing the trigger more smoothly and slowly rather than rushing from on to off throttle. This way, we can find the pinnacle point of traction and speed through the car. It's important if you don't use traction control that you follow this method. Now, when you're positioning your hands on the controller, it's important to make yourself as comfortable as possible. Leave your right thumb over the top of both upshift and downshift buttons. This will allow you to upshift and downshift with minimal movement of your right thumb. For people that do not use ABS, it is also pretty difficult to brake. The best method is to brake at 100% as soon as you reach the brake marker and then release your brake slowly to form trail braking. This is totally dependent on the corner, but this applies to most situations. So let's see how we apply these methods in practice. Here we are in Brazil, going up through the long left-hander that turns us onto the pit straight. We are not constantly adjusting the left analog stick toward the left, and that is because I've positioned the left analog stick in a way in the arc that does not require me to constantly stab it towards the left. Going through these corners, turns 1 and 2, left to right, I do not rush through full lock left to full lock right. I go through every degree that is capable on this controller using the arc method. Once again, I lean on the circular rim before entering a corner. Press the analog stick forward before rotating it to the left or right using the rim, and take as much of the left or right side as you need as you go through the corner. It's important that you don't constantly correct the analog stick or the steering wheel on the game, so that way you can provide a smoother movement while going through a corner, which is faster. This in turn will also reduce your tire wear as you are providing a smoother movement from the transition of weight distribution in the car. As you employ this method, you will be a lot more accurate when hitting apexes of corners and you'll reduce sliding out the car. Once again, this method is applicable to all racing games that are somewhat realistic. This is definitely not the fastest lap around Brazil, but I only did this for demonstration purposes. And to find an idea of what not to do in the game, which will lose you time, here is an example. We do not want to constantly correct this car going into the left corner by stabbing the left analog stick towards the left hand side of the rim. This may take a lot of practice to get used to, but it's definitely for the best. Hopefully this guide has been helpful, and don't forget, smooth is fast. If you liked the tutorial, be sure to leave a like and subscribe for more content. I also do league racing and top 5 overtakes of the week and all the other good stuff, so be sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss a thing. Until then, I'll see you all in the next one.